Welcome back, everyone. For some reason, I always love the action movies from the 80s. RoboCop, Die Hard, Conan, Rambo, Predator, Commando. I mean, there's something really special about them. So in this build, I will make a prop from one of these movies. I will make the Night Slasher's knife from Cobra with Sylvester Stallone. So stick around.
Stick around.
And if you feel like it, you may like and subscribe. But for now, well, let's build it. I'm done with the basic shape of my blade. Of course, this operation would be way faster using a plasma cutter or a water jet, but I don't have one, so instead it took a bit longer. We don't want things to be too easy, do we? So now I am going to jump on the grinding of the blade itself using my belt grinder, so let's get to it. It's not perfect, but it's good enough for me. So now I'm gonna jump on the bevel over there and I'm gonna do it with the Dremel tool. Off to the spikes. One done, 9 more to go.
I am done cleaning up the plastic handles. And on the blade itself, I forgot to do something earlier. On the original design, there are a couple of notches on the top of the blade for the thumb, for a good grip, something like this. I'm gonna do that right now. That looks all right. Now for, well, the fun part, the skull logo on the blade itself. And what I mean by fun part is that I will try something that I have never done before, which is metal casting. In order to do that, I asked one of my friends to model the skull in ZBrush based on the reference I had. And then I 3D printed that model to generate what would be the negative space for my mold. And finally, my plan is to use my kid's kinetic sand to, well, make the mold, melt some aluminum, pour it in there, and hope for the best. Let's get to it. So as you can see, I failed a few times before actually getting the level of details I was looking for. And for the first time, I have to say that I'm really happy with the result. And now I believe it's time to wrap up this blade, so let's get it done.